back when I was a child, before life removed all the innocence, my father would lift me high and dance with my mother and me, and then spin me around till I fell asleep. Then up the stairs he would carry me, and I knew for sure I was loved. If I could get another chance, another walk, another dance with him, I'd play a song that would never, ever end. How I'd love, love, love to dance with my father again. Ooh. When I and my mother would disagree, to get my way I would run from her to him. He'd make me laugh just to comfort me, yeah, yeah. Then finally make me do just what my mama said. Later that night when I was asleep, he left a dollar under my sheet. Never dreamed that he would be gone from me. One final step, one final dance with him, I'd play a song that would never, ever end. Cause I'd love, love, love to dance with my father again. Sometimes I'd listen outside her door, and I'd hear how my mother cried for him. I pray for her even more than me. I pray for her even more than me. I know she loved. I know you don't do it usually, but dear Lord, she's dying to dance with my father again. Every night I fall asleep, and this is all I ever dream.
building of God, and house not made with hands, eternally in the heavens. He brought nothing into this world, and it is certain that we can carry nothing forward. The Lord gave, and the Lord will take away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
We will continue as we sing the opening hymn. Some that morning we shall rise, we shall see Jesus.
Praise the name of the Lord Jesus. Stay here. And we're giving God thanks. Amen? Because the Lord knows what he's doing. We're going to pray at this time. Father, in your name, Jesus. Lord, we honor you this afternoon, God. We give you praise and thanks, Lord God. We glorify your name, Jesus. We lift you up because you are worthy of all our praises, Lord God. Worthy to receive glory and honor and praise, Lord God. Jesus, you are God all by yourself. Father, even now, God, as we have come into this house, Lord God, we want to thank you, oh God, for the privilege that we have, Lord God, to even walk in here today, Lord God. As we have gathered, Jesus, hallelujah, oh my God, hallelujah, to have this humbling service for our dearly beloved brother, Lord God. We pray in the name of the Lord Jesus, hallelujah, in a special way, Lord God, for this service. Let this service be talked about, Lord God. Let somebody remember the service, Lord God, and the impact that this service will have, Lord God. Father, I come right now and commit before you, Lord God, the immediate family, Lord God. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus, as Lord God, they have come, Lord God, and planned, Lord God, and they are here today, Lord God, to pay their last respects, Lord God. Father, I pray you come on them in a special way. Lord God, breathe upon them, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, for Sister Sims, Lord God, and the children, Lord God Almighty, and all, Lord God, the other family members, Lord God, the church family, everybody who is affected right now in the name of Jesus. Father, as we are here, God, lead the proceedings for the day, Lord God. Show yourself strong. Yes, God, we are gathered for our funeral service, but we are going to give you praise. We are going to give you glory. We are going to give you honor, Lord God. And Lord God, we know that if our brother was here, he would have loved to see somebody come to know you, Father. Father, show yourself strong today. Lead somebody to your revelation of the truth of your word, Lord God Almighty, and cause somebody to leave the service saying, I will surrender all to Jesus. Father, we present everything before you, every tribute, Lord God, every aspect that the service shall take, Lord God, the choir, the musicians, and everybody, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, as we grieve together, we pray you hold us, Lord God, as only you are able to comfort, you are able to console. Father, we pray, Lord God, for the word that shall come forth today. Oh, my God, cause it to reach somebody's heart. Oh, that on this day, hallelujah, as we put away our brother, somebody came to know you, Jesus. Have your way and show yourself strong in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Evangelist Fuse. You may be seated. And I want to greet everyone in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I must express our deepest condolences to Missionary Sims, the children and the grandchildren, and other relatives. We are here to celebrate this afternoon. Oh, we don't reach afternoon yet. This morning, we are here to celebrate the life of our brother.
Sorry, just asking the car that is parked in the driveway just to move, facilitate some of the movements. I only got 9989. I'm not sure the letters. All right. Thank you very much.
Okay. I was saying we are here to celebrate the life of a man of God who has walked with his Savior for many years. As we reflect his life, we want to give God thanks that he really showed himself to be a strong man in the hand of God. The Apostolic Church, the Sadducees Apostolic Church, really recognize, really give honor to God for this, our faithful brother. Praise God. And as we come together, yes, there may be sadness somewhere around in our hearts. The family, the immediate family may be mourning. But I know that beyond that, there's a joy in their hearts because our brother had lived a life well lived. At this time, Elder Huff will be bringing greetings from the church. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And greetings and welcome to everyone that are gathered here this morning. We are here because someone has passed on. But we are here today, and although we grieve, we are not grieving as those that have no hope. But we have a hope in the Lord Jesus Christ. And I would like to say to missionary Sims, his widow, and to all his children, and to all his grandchildren, which I know are many, and to everyone that are gathered here, on behalf of our pastor and every member of the Santa Cruz Apostolic Church, we heartily welcome you. And we are here today because our brother has lived his life. We are not here to make any pronouncement. For God is the final arbiter. And he knows everything about every one of us that are here. And I believe that Brother Sim's greatest joy would be that those who are not yet saved give their life to the Lord Jesus Christ. And I can remember clearly the song that he loved to sing so well. Choir bells of heaven, how sweetly they ring. I believe, according to the scripture, that wherever he is today, he is hearing these prayer bells ringing, hearing the message.
Everyone who is coming from out of town, the relatives coming from abroad also. So happy that we're not in COVID anymore. So, really, yes, yes, yes. It is a little bit still around, but truly, we're out of it. Not 100%, but when you think of where we're coming from, we could have a service like this some time ago. So happy to have the relatives. Glad you are here, and friends who are coming, I see Sister Nadine coming in. Praise the Lord also. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Pastor is seated and his wife also. I'm happy that we have made some space for them. Praise the Lord. So we'll continue as we have our first lesson taken from Psalm 90, verse 1 to 6. And it will be read by Britannia Sims and Jerica Taylor, granddaughters of our beloved Robert Donald. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Okay, they are getting themselves ready.
Our first lesson is taken from Psalms 90, verse 1 to 6. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever, thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction, and sayest, return, ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday, when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as with a flood. They are as a sheep in the morning. They are like grass which groweth up. Last verse. In the morning it flourisheth and groweth up. In the evening it is cut down and withered. Sleep on that.
Praise the Lord. Sleep on that. Indeed, he's taken a rest until that great triumphant morning. Praise the Lord with me, somebody.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. When the saints of God shall rise to meet our Savior in the sky. Praise the Lord. We move on to tribute. We have three tributes here with Sister Reeve Salmon, the Santa Cruz Apostolic Church, and the Santa Cruz Apostolic Choir Praise Team. Please come in that order, and I will not come back to make another announcement. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Let me take this grand opportunity to extend warm and heartfelt greetings to Bishop Salter and his loving wife, Pastor James and his wife, Elder Huff, Evangelist Hughes, moderator, musicians, the bereaved family, congregants, mourners. I just want to reiterate the point that the others had just said, that we assemble here not to have, we celebrate. We assemble here. I want to hear silence. I just want to reiterate the point that we assemble here today to have a celebratory time. I said celebratory because we are all aware of the fact that Brother Sims had lived a fulfilled life, one that was pleasing to the Lord. The psalmist David confirmed it by saying, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighted in his way. So we are not mourning for Brother Sims as one without hope. Amen?
Amen.
Okay, now tribute for the late Donald Sims. We can't explain why computer programs get corrupted and our work evaporates into cyberspace any more than we can explain why bodies get diseased and our loved ones are taken away from us in death. But we can shout with the psalmist David and with sparkling eyes, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. And so today we celebrate the life of Donald Sims. Juan Rees wrote, and I quote, "There are two deaths, the real one and the one people know about. And God, in his mercy, had bestowed those two deaths on Donald Sims." Brother Sims was a very ambitious man. And so during his early 20s, he started to have big dreams. And like Martin Luther King Jr., he said, "I have a dream that very soon I want to marry the woman of my life. I have a dream that I want to marry a beautiful chocolate color, loving, caring young lady who is also chubby, plump, with Coca-Cola shape." He shared Solomon's words of wisdom in Proverbs 18 verse 22, and I quote, "Whoso findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtaineth favor of the Lord." End of quote. Brother Sims was not one of those persons who lays in bed. He had his daily itinerary, and so he rose early in the mornings so as to complete the day's activities. Brother Sims was a workaholic. He would mind if there were no nights, so he could work right around the clock. He strongly believed that lazy people should neither eat nor drink. Being an aesthetic type of person, he believed that cleanliness is next to. So the first thing he would do in the mornings was to ensure that the yard was well swept and immaculately clean while singing his favorite chorus, "Your grace and mercy won." After this task was completed, he would make his way to the kitchen where his dear wife was preparing his breakfast, which he would normally take with him. As usual, he would ask, "Mommy, you ready for me now?" If his wife replied, "Just 5 minutes time more, Daddy," he would respond, "We are running late, we can't wait for it." And he would slip away, leaving it because of the urgency to go down to the field to feed the cows, after which he would venture out in various places to do pickup and delivery. This man work commenced from 5 a.m. to 6 p.m. Monday to Saturday. He was always busily working, either loading or unloading goods onto or off the truck or pickup, or lying flat on his back under the truck fixing it, or standing with the truck bonnet lifted with a spanner in his hand, knocking the starter gear in order to release it. Whenever we were at home and heard the banging sound, my husband would say, Mr. Sims, reach home now, I'm working on his truck. Tara, Richie, and Brent were also in his company, assisting and learning the skills at the same time. Very rare, he would take his vehicles to the mechanic shop. He, Tara, Richie, and Brent did the job themselves. I said, Tara.
Tara.
Surprisingly, Sister Sims, Faith, and Peaches, who were occasional onlookers, didn't grasp the mechanical skills. Mr. Sims took his work so seriously that whenever his wife gave him his bag with his nutritious breakfast, he forgot to eat, hence it would be returned home. He had so much to accomplish for the day that he deprived himself of food. Can you imagine? Brother Sims strongly believed that it was better to be a doorkeeper in the house of God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. So his spiritual conviction was grounded right here at the Santa Cruz Apostolic Church, where he was an ardent worshiper. He took his Christian life very seriously. On Sundays and whenever any church activities were taking place, Brother Sims would lay aside all manual work and was exquisitely attired in his jacket suit to come to the house of God with his dear wife to worship. To him, God came first in his life. Brother Sims emulated St. Paul's advice to rejoice always in the Lord. This was evident in the fact that there was not a dull moment in his life. He was not put down by his problems. Even when his truck was giving him problems, or when he was going through his illness, he tried to keep the sunshine on his face. This aspect of his personality had caused him to be on good terms with all persons who came in contact with him, not to mention his doctors and nurses at the university hospital who had developed a close bond with him. Sims just didn't complain or grumble about anything. That man always smiling, because he was fully convinced that the God whom he worshipped had everything in his control. And as I mentioned about complaint, the story is told about this young lady, Mary. She has a lovely farm with various crops, like watermelon, lettuce, cabbage, cucumber, you name it. This lady is always grumbling, always complaining, never pleased about anything. If she meets a young man who is interested in her, she remarks, "You're tall and handsome, but your pocket is weak." And if she meets another one, she'll comment, "Your pocket is strong, but you're not intelligent." And if the rain falls for two consecutive days, she complains of too much water affecting the crops. And if the rain doesn't fall for two consecutive days, she complained that the drought will cause her crops to dry. You would never find Brother Sims complaining. So everyone admires the beautiful crown she has on her form. One day her pastor visited her form and said, Sister Mary, your crops are so healthy and pretty. Everyone in and around the area is talking about how healthy and pretty your crops look. Listen, Sister Mary, in her usual sour manner, she replied, true pastor, the crops are really looking good, but what am I going to do when I need bad ones to feed the pigs? Can you imagine? In our community, Brother Sims was our unsung hero, a magnanimous person who utilized his selfless talent to offer assistance to persons in and out of the community. Despite the fact that he was not a certified mechanic, he could be seen walking briskly with his spanner and other related tools to assist any motorist who was experiencing difficulty. I can recall quite vividly when our vehicle was giving problem, and Brother Sims could be seen coming with his tool to assist. Another remarkable feature of Brother Sims is that whenever our road was in a deplorable condition, filled with numerous potholes, Brother Sims always took the initiative to have the road repaired. He didn't wait on any politician. He made consultation with us, the motorists residing in the community. See, my help to end it here. Okay. Brother Sims loved his children and grandchildren dearly, especially his granddaughter Olivia and daughter Peaches. I don't know if it's because my aquatic shirt tells me that peaches are round juicy fruits. He would frequently refer to Peaches as his nurse. Peaches was the one who would assist her mother in attending to his personal health care. Whenever he needed Peaches, he asked, when the nurse said, come help me nurse. Peaches moved with alacrity to his assistance. Now,
just a moment. Hello, hello everyone. I'd like you to listen to me, please. We're asking you to be quiet, please. Give us a break. We like to see and to hear discipline wherever we are. And I don't know what the conversation in the congregation is, but I'd like you to just put that out now. Allow the person to just finish what she is doing. Please. Well, she's finished.
Now, Brother Sims, all good things must come to an end. Unfortunately, the latter quarter of 2019 took an ugly twist on Brother Sims' lifestyle. He started to ail, and this prolonged illness had resulted in his immobility. He was then referred by his physician to see a neurosurgeon at the hospital. In March 2020, during the same period that COVID visited our island, Brother Sims' condition had deteriorated to the point where he underwent three major surgeries. On Tuesday, March 14, 2023, at precisely level 06, the ubiquitous hands of death came to snatch him away, so he closed his eyes and swept away peacefully. What a good way to die. That was his way of demonstrating what Paul said to Timothy, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept it clean. At age 76, some people continue to soar in life, but God has seen it suitable to soar the North Seas to higher heights, where he will be free from all sicknesses, diseases, and of course, he won't have the problems and trials of this life to reckon with. We all join in saying, we'll see you in the morning, Brother Sims. May your soul rest in peace and light perpetually shine upon you.
Yeah. spoke passionately of God's grace and mercy that brought him through the challenges of life. Our brother loved to sing. For many years, he was an ardent member of the church choir. He was ready to sing. One youth Sunday, when the youth choir was to sing, Brother Sidney was sitting on the chair, and surely he sang with them, moving his body to the rhythm of the song. Among his favorite songs were, let us hear that one. Showed willingness and commitment in what he did. From the early years of the church, he used his motor vehicle to transport brethren and visitors to and from church. He was so serious about his duties that at times his children had to walk while he assists those that live far from church. Missionary Sims reminds us that at times she would wait until he finished the last trip.
Amen.
Amen, Missionary Sims. Not only was our brother a transporter or a driver, but he played the role of an usher, making sure that things were right in the house of the Lord. In the early years of our church, Brother Sims assisted at the music at the baptismal service at New River. Praise the Lord, that's why we didn't have a pool here. He was the leader of the crew of brothers who would provide manual labor. These activities include bushing the surrounding of the church, erecting tents for special occasions and fundraising. His loving wife, Missionary Sims, who rendered her loving and caring service, said, one day, while Brother Sim was lying in bed, he inquired, what about the pushing of the surrounding of the church? Sister Sims assured him that Elder Cuff and others would are taking care. His attendance to church was severely affected by his medical condition. Prayers were made on his behalf in abundance. We long to see him again in the sanctuary, but we were encouraged to hear that he was in constant communion with the Lord, both at home and at the hospital. Our hearts melted that morning as we received the dreadful news of his passing. However, we were comforted by the words of the psalmist, which says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. The Santa Cruz Apostolic Church has lost a faithful brother who will live in our memories.
Amen.
Death for a child of God is just a sleep.
Yes.
To rest for a temporary period, to rise when the trump of God shall sound. That is greater reminds us in this quote, we cannot, Lord, thy purpose see, but all is well that's done by thee. To missionary sins, children, grandchildren, host of other relatives and friends, be comforted. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Brother Sims is gone with a hope of seeing his maker, where the joy bells will sing sweetly throughout the countless ages of eternity. Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Grandpa, for showing me how to live a life without compromise.
Thank you for showing me what walking in humility and love is all about. I know my Grandpa was not only an inspiration to me, but to so many of us as well. So today, I am sure he would want you to leave here, not in mourning, but rejoice in life. Daddy, I love you. Sleep. Many years old, rest in peace.
Of our Southern Church Brotherhood Department, Brother Kevin will be making a tribute, and also Brother Greg Austin will also be making a tribute. So Brother Kevin and Brother Austin, please present your church.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Brother seems to be rejoicing at this moment.
Yeah.
Let me say all protocol observed for the, you know, time is running away from us. And I see a lot of panic going on. So I know your heart. Daddy Sims. Wonderful man. Kind man, family man, hard-working man. Brother seems that he was a listening ear. He was help. People here today show the type of person he was. I've been fortunate to be at his house, you know, going to work, and my mind has said, go up there. It was rough, but God knows best. Family, take comfort that he died in the Lord. He's sleeping, as Jesus said. And one day we know he will rise again. So take courage. He lived his life. And this is a testament of Brother Sims. Continue to be strong. Continue to be there for each other. Observe you guys a couple nights, and I tell you, God bless your family. Continue to be strong for each other. Continue to be there. God bless you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
A tribute to Brother Don's sins. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. According to 1 Thessalonians 4, verses 13 to 14. But I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them that are asleep, that he sorrow not even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also who sleep in Jesus will God reign with him. I want to greet District Elder Marcel and Missionary Cynthia James and all the officers of the St. Joseph Apostolic Church, and a very special greeting to the bereaved family. For the next 3 minutes, I will share a tribute in beautiful memory of Brother Sims. And I thank you for the opportunity. And I take the liberty of sharing this tribute with some older young people who were here at the time: Keon, Keisha, Clyde, Jessica, Donette, O'Neill, Richard, and there are some young people too, Philip, Elroy, Trisha, and Jessan, and but they were younger then. Look at them now. So much for age, right? Keon and Andre, very quickly, came to Jamaica last October, and they had one commitment which they kept, and they were happy. They visited their brother Sims, and they were very glad they did. When Sister Sims told them it was them, he started crying and telling them how much he loved them. They were very blessed though, and got the opportunity and a chance to have prayed with him one last time. I was privileged to visit Brother Sims last in the hospital. And I was in a uniform then and wondered if he would make me out. Well, he did and smiled. And subsequently told the nurses I was his church brother. I too had the opportunity to pray with him, and I will speak about four outstanding attributes or aspects of my church brother, Brother Sims. The laugh, the voice, the rock, and the truck. Our journey, Brother Sims, started before many of us were born, because we came to church, grew up in church, seeing Brother Sims. And he was a worshiper. He would sing the songs of Zion with a glad heart. He was a genuine and loving father, brother, husband. But most of all, a worshiper. The voice. So, for those who may not have known, Brother Sims had one of the most outstanding tenor voices I've heard. You heard it when he was asked to lead testimonies, and of course, his favorite song would be? Wonderful. Yes, you got it right. But if you were privileged to be at choir practices back then, you would understand the technique behind the voice. When Brother Sims was supposed to sing high, he would tip. And when the note should go lower down, Brother Sims would pull his head, leaning to one side. Then there was the laugh. Brother Sims was extremely pleasant and had an infectious laugh, which you realize within seconds of seeing him. Growing up, we didn't know whether or not he had a bad day or even had any obstacles or struggles in life. He was always wearing a smile. Whether or not he had a bad or a good day, he was just a joyful, joyous person. And, you know, he exuded that unspeakable joy that the world did not give. There were the difficult times and moments of getting a song right. When himself, along with the other tenor singer, Sister Snowball, and Brother Clive at the time, would struggle to get a line correctly. I don't know if you remember this song that we turned around, sweeping, we go sweeping, that's how, yeah. When Brother Sims couldn't get that, he just closed his eyes and burst out in laughter at that line. That was just Brother Sims. Then there was the truck. So Brother Sims was known to be an industrious man and provider to his family, had an extremely good work ethic. As kids, we look forward to Brother Sims driving in his truck to and from church, as this was excitement for us, whether or not we came to church with him. Once he got here and he was leaving, so he was parked somewhere over that side, we would get on the truck or van later on, and we would get a drive from here, believe it or not, up to the road. And that was awesome for the children. You never imagine. When Brother Sims did not come to church, it was a huge disappointment, because even though we were not traveling with him, when he got up there and geared, and I thought it was deliberate, we would just go forward and backward as the gear down. Wonderful. Later on, when Brother Sims started to drive a smaller van than a car, we just thought he was out of place. Then there was the rock. And by the rock, I mean the dance. He had a unique rock. You couldn't miss it. You just had to realize that it was there. Whether he was in the pew, whether he was at the choir, whether or not he was up here leading, there was that rock. Now, it won't be feet, but there was a feet pin to it. And he went from side to side. Wonderful. That was his way of maintaining the rhythm, which you could not interrupt for any reason at all. Brother Sims was always so kind. He never stopped giving. He loved young people. And he always encouraged us to keep serving the Lord. His transition would certainly leave a void in his family, his church family and community. And we as young people, or then young people, will surely miss him. Blessed are the dead who died in the Lord. They will rest from their labors and their works will follow them. Sleep on, Brother Sims. Not so long from now, we will catch up. God bless
you. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you, Deacon Shaw and Minister Brett, for your wonderful tributes. We are rolling on. And Minister Brett said just a while ago that Brother Sims loved to give. And we're going to follow that example as we make an offertory contribution this afternoon. And we will be asking the ushers to get in your place as we take the offering at this time. So the choir and praise the first. Who will get yourselves ready? Ushers, get it ready too. Offer to our kids.
storehouse in my God. Jesus.
You may be seated. Praise the God. What will it be? Oh, we just can't imagine. But it will be great. Hallelujah. As we get over there, no more sickness, no more pain, not even death, but forever, to the countless ages of eternity, we shall be praising the Lord. Praise the Lord. Bishop Salter is here with us, and at this time, he will be greeting the church in the name of the Lord.
Come on, let's clap our hands for the Lord Jesus. Put your hands together for the Lord Jesus. Is the God wonderful? Is the God wonderful? Praise God, praise God. We're so thankful to be here this morning, this afternoon, joining in this celebration. Everybody say celebration. It's indeed a celebration. Greetings to Pastor James, his dear wife, all of the ministers, Missionary Sims. I greet Sister Joy, praise God, who's overcome by the occasion. And I understand all the other members of the family, all the children, grandchildren, friends and well wishers. And the turnout is really a testament to the life and times of Brother Donald Sims, who have lived his life. And I listened to the testimonies and the tributes, and it is certain that during his life of times, it's been his calling and his election sure. And that is not something that none of us ever will ever get accustomed to. And so in the times in which we live, it's very important that we pay attention to sunrise, the time in which we were born, to the time in which the Lord takes us. So the Bible says death is an appointment. Appointment. And how is it that we are prepared to keep his appointment? And so Brother Donald Sims, he made his appointment and ensured that when the Lord decides to take him home, he would have completed his appointment. So it has nothing to do with age. Nothing to do with age. Not at all. Some goes young and some goes a little older. And so today, as we celebrate this time, I want to encourage those of us who are still alive that this is an appointment. And one day, as sure as fate, we're going to find ourselves in this very position. What is it that we say? And what will people say? Let's ensure that as we live our lives, we make sure that this day is a day that we complete the appointment that life has set before us. God bless you. God bless you. Greet my dear wife, likewise, who traveled with me today to be here with us. Stand up with this assault and just say, praise the Lord. All right. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
Thank you, Bishop. And we will continue with some more tributes. And a selection will come first from Sister Winston Barnes. And she's making that for Sister Nadine Sims Carter, the daughter of our dear beloved brother. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Please worship as I sing this song on behalf of Nadine. Amen. Amen.
When I'm alone in the Spirit, I find lonely, me
for
the love knows.
Thank you. Amen.
And he lifted his mouth.
Amen.
And brother, since part
things, which is free, which Brother Sims really are hard work. I think they were completely asleep. Brother Sims told me in sleep and told me what last night to make life. Sleeping and being shot. Trust God, don't find it in his ear. He taught me about when he's not by praying to bush. He told me God himself. Take him out and he wouldn't land there. Okay, yes. Who can't never? Brother Sims was a man of God. Yes. Loved people. Yes. Little children is feeding daily. Little children is feeding daily. Let me tell you something. He had one great granddaughter. She should be here today, but she not yet to come. He's growing up Brother Sims' hand. And when Brother Sims come on river, he put himself on the veranda. Because Brother Sims can hear all these berries, either one guava or one club. You can't put in her hand. And when you put in her hand, she was thrown on the back of the river. So Brother, Mr. Sims, give the grandfather, Mr. Sims come. Mr. Sims come. Let me tell you something, Brother Sims is a man of God. And we don't even have to worry where he is. We don't even have to ask. Where he is, we know that he's somewhere around the shoulder of God. He's somewhere around the shoulder of God. And God bless you. And keep you in Jesus.
Thank you.
service, Mr. Gray and the other brothers who are with him. We want to express our gratitude for his favor this afternoon. May the Lord continue to bless them. Praise the Lord. And we have our final set of tributes. And you know, sometimes when you are sharing, the food gets small. So those who are at the top get more. Those at the bottom get a little bit. So these other tributes, you are down to 2 minutes or less. And boy, I know you have a lot to say. But I know whatever you have to say, somebody say it already. Unless it's personal. Praise the Lord. So, Miss Sonia, Miss Shirley, and Sister Gloria, come in that order, please. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, brethren.
Praise the Lord.
I'm not sure if my aunt is here as yet, but we're still going to praise the Lord and do what we have to do. Do we believe in the second coming of Christ?
Yes.
Amen?
Amen?
Amen. If we believe in the second coming of Christ, then we'll see Uncle Donald again, because he has lived that life that we'll see him when Christ comes again.
I heard the sound.
Thank you.
down things. And great salt. A great soul serves everyone, all the time. A great soul never dies. It brings us together again and again, by Maya Angelou. Donald Sims was really a great soul with whom I became acquainted over the past 20 years when my niece, Mrs. Barrett Bryan, moved from Appleton to live in Santa Cruz. The Sims family became her neighbors and eventually her family friends. They shared such a good relationship that Mr. Sims was daddy to her and she was mommy to him. Because of this, that bond, I was drawn into the circle and became auntie to the Sims family. And Mr. Sims was daddy to me. He was respectful and pleasant person and always greeted me with a warm smile. His kindness, quiet and gentle demeanor endures him to my heart and no doubt to the hearts of all those gathered here today. A diligent and hardworking person, daddy loves and cares for his family. He did everything in his powers to provide for them. A real papa bear. He was jack of all trades, fixing his trucks and cars, fixing vents to keep in his cows, tending to his animals and doing odd jobs around the house. He was never too busy to help someone and did so willingly. He was the perfect community member, being one of the first person to be out to help with road work in the community on Labor Day. Since Daddy became ill and unable to move around, there had been no more Labor Day project in this area. So sad. Daddy was a fighter, and even in his illness, he was always positive, kept his faith in God. My niece recalled that in his pain, she told him to call on Jesus, and that he did. She always encouraged him and made him smile, and even had some good laugh, even when pain was rocking his body. She had a special love for him, and he loved her too, and openly expressed this. Daddy fought a good fight. He had kept the faith, and he will be justly rewarded on that great day. Let us not mourn as those who have no hope, but let us cherish the precious memories he has left us. We wish farewell in your journey to eternity. Daddy, you will never be forgotten. Sleep in peace.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
God is good. Tribute to Donald Sims, a.k.a. Wallace Sims. A million times we have needed you. A million times we have cried. If love alone could have saved you, you never would have died. If all the world was ours to give, we would give it, yes, and more, to see you coming up the church steps and walking through the door, to have your voice and see you smile, to sit and listen to your melodious voice, singing your favorite songs, Pearls of Heaven. To be with you that same old way, this would be our fondest day. A heart of gold stopped beating, two smiling eyes
He only takes the best. Today, we celebrate a loved, a life well-loved and forever cherished. The Lord has seen the fulfilling and Christian life of our brother. On March 14, 2023, the Lord looked down on our brother, stretched forth his loving hands towards him and said, "You have labored long, and now you deserve rest. Come, brother, I will give you rest. Brother Sims, may your soul rest in peace."
Redemption story. Oh, I shall see. I wish I was by your bedside when you were ready to leave me for good. Although you are now in the arms of Jesus and your spirit is right here with us as you celebrate your life. If love and care could save you, you would still be here. If money could save you, even then, Daddy, you know you would still be here for sure. However, because you got tired of this world and God prepared you for a time of rest, I am happy to celebrate a beautiful soul with a life well lived. Daddy, I am very much heartbroken. But remembering your life story brings me some comfort. From childhood days, you taught us to know the Lord for ourselves. As we had church at home as children, you would be in the midst, and after our church session, we would laugh at some of the funniest testimonies given by our other siblings. Daddy, you taught us how to be very independent. I look forward to when you gave us our weekly stipend. And even then, you would have given us extra when you told us to do extra. As I grew older, while in high school, you taught me how to be industrious by employing me on weekends, hence earning my own income. Daddy, as a child, I remember staying up in the night until you are home from work, receive my hugs before I go to bed, not knowing that you would do the same when I was preparing for my external exams in fifth form. Right now, I am remembering clearly how you would leave your matrimonial bed to stay with me while I studied, no matter how I told you I am okay. I know many persons may have seen me cry, but Daddy, you are the best. Your question to me would be, and I quote, "What happened to my baby now?" And this is what made the world of difference. I felt warm and protected in your arms, even to adulthood, and I mean, even when I became a wife and a mother. Daddy, you made an effort to protect us as a family. But Daddy, you made me feel super special. Living in Montego Bay, you know, I came home every weekend. And when I was coming home, he was always on the phone. He didn't stop calling until he knew that I was at the Esoges station there to pick me up, take me home. And I'm talking, as old as I am, if my father was still alive, he would still be doing that. He cared for his family in such a way. You are a one in a million father who cannot be forgotten. As children, we would take home our parents, and that would mean nothing to you. You showed love to everyone unconditionally, resulting in many children who are not biological, and I really admire that great quality of yours. You are equally caring, loving, and protective to all as long as they were staying at your house. Greatest dad ever. And I'm going to cut out some. Daddy Christoph, your grandson, wants you to know that he loves you dearly, and he's missing you so much. Making it short, goodbye, Daddy, Dad, Papa, we will always love you. But now, you are in addition to the band of angels singing in heaven choir. And now, my battle is over. I am wearing my crown in the new Jerusalem.
Jesus, come here, Lord, we pray you, cover the time.
of special prayers now. Hallelujah. We are celebrating. And different things happen in a celebration. Our sister is a little bit exhausted. We need some fresh air first of all. Two clothes. Two persons are closed. Her head needs to be down, so the oxygen can flow. We have to use our wisdom here. We have the nurse of the house. The nurse of the house.
Outside, Understand that things are not in the hand of man, but in the hand of God. Paul was preaching one night, and he preached until one man that was sitting in the window fell asleep. I said something deep in sleep, and he fell from where he was, dropped on the floor, broke his neck, and Paul continued to preach. He paid any mind, and when he finished giving the word of God, he went down and command life in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, God answers prayer. Years ago, I was at a church preaching one night. When I was preaching, while I was there, everybody was listening attentively. But afterwards, I saw a group down in the back circling somebody. Nobody seemed to be paying attention to the preacher. So it didn't make sense for me to preach. The Lord sent me down to where she was, and when I went there, touched her, she was cold, she was sweaty, her eyes were turning over. And I just put my hand around her and grabbed her. I didn't even pray, because I saw that life was either gone or going out of this woman. And I just praised her and said, Jesus, life, life. And she turned her eyes over. And I went back to the pulpit and continued my message. When we had the altar call, I looking down, I didn't see her. When I looked, Bishop, she was standing at the altar. God delivered her. Not my prayer, because I said I didn't pray. I just preached her and said, Lord, life, life. And movement came. And she was able to walk to the altar. After service, I said, give her some tea. And she drank her tea and went home. Might have been years after I saw it pass and thought, who's that lady? She went and moving up and down. So God is a prisoner in time of trouble. Let us continue to pray for Lady Singh, Missionary Singh's and family. God has been strengthening them. I don't know how much I've been able to go into the Bible, but whatever the Lord has helped to say today, I'm going to say it. But God has been strengthening them.
Yes, amen.
And Sister Singh's, life is still here for you. You still have the rest of your family. And we just continue to trust God to support the family. The support is there. I look at Sister Gibbon, Sister Joy. And what I see God doing for her, and she exhibited strength and courage. It's not all human. It is God. She's just in everything from beginning to this point. Sister, God has strengthened you. And he will not leave you. He is going to continue to strengthen and to bless you and the family. Brother Sims has been a friend and a brother to us all, and so especially to me and my family, we like to fry fish not on the stove, but on the wood fire on the outside. Brother Singh would never let my house run short of wood. And when it is going out, he comes, bring them to the house, he takes his ox, and he split them up, and said, I'll get more for you, and he packed me up, and go. So my wife enjoy her fried fish, not just for the home, but for friends and abroad, or family abroad. Sorry, especially my daughter, Kim did not get to come today. And I know she had her tribute. I don't know if it reached here, but accept condolences from her family, from Keisha, and from all of those abroad. It's good to have friends around us. And thank God we have been sharing good fellowship. There's much more to say, but we say that as we go along. Here we are today to put away the remains of our beloved brother Sings. If we call him at the hospital, we sing the song for him. Prayer bells are ringing. We just try to find one of those songs that he loves to sing, and we have to mention that before we part and before we was in the hospital, called and prayed for him, and you know he likes to cry. He cried. And he said, my pastor. Whenever we meet and pray, my pastor. But Brother Sings, you know, worshiper. He sings, he cries, he shouts, he testifies. And when he finished from the altar singing and shouting, he comes to the altar to finish crying and seeking God. I trust we are seeking the Lord today. If we are saved, we need to seek the Lord. If we are not saved, we need to seek the Lord. Because he is the one that gives life and gives more abundantly. The devil wants to stop at all times, just from a long time. He wants to stop the word of God. He wants to stop the blessing that God is carrying out to his people. But every time he tries, he fails. Yes. And he would not be ashamed and just stop trying. He's going to try until he has no more opportunity to try. For certainly, he will fail every time. But God meant that we should have life and have it more abundant. And I'm going to read a little from whatever the Lord allows me to read today. I have more than one scripture, but in St. Matthew, chapter 1. Praise the Lord. God intends to save mankind from our sin, rescue us out of our miserable situation, and God is not running around to find a plan as how to save his people. He has already had that plan before the foundation of the world. Jesus Christ is declared as the Savior of the world. And before he was born, it was prophesied that he would come. Virgin shall conceive. Amen. A virgin is going to bring forth a son. and that virgin's name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. Because if he is going to save people from our sins, he had to be God. For nobody else can save one from his or her sin except God. And that's why when Jesus was here in the flesh and he spoke to the sick and said, "Thy sin be forgiven thee," they were ready to stone him, because the Jews knew that only God can forgive sin. And they did not believe that Jesus was God. So with all the miracles that he was working, they were ready to stone him, Bishop. Instead of them looking to see what God is doing, if somebody say, "Your sin be forgiven," you have to be God. But they were so stuck in their belief that Jesus was just a man trying to put over and to exhibit himself. But because he was not one that was exhibiting himself, he was opening something to the people, and he said to the man, "Thy sin be forgiven." So when the story began, he asked them the question, which is easy, to say thy sin be forgiven, or to say to the sick, "Arise, take up your bed and walk." The Bible said, he turned to the sick and said, "Arise, take up your bed and walk." Hallelujah. And he that was sick took up his bed and walked. Manifesting that the first statement that he said was true, and what they were talking about, amen, only God can do it, was true. But they did not believe that he was God. But to show you that I am God who forgives you, I'm adding to it, to the sick, that you can do nothing about, take up your bed and walk. And they watch him take up his bed and walk. We have to celebrate the birth of such a woman. Hallelujah. And all of us here today, and we're not talking about finding about the birthday of Jesus and come together, killing goats, amen, killing cows, and having a good time talking about the Lord. But we are being excited and ready today to celebrate the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ, because his birth has brought salvation from up to us and deliverance from death and judgment. Hallelujah. We who are saved, baptized in Jesus' name, filled with the Holy Ghost, walking with the Lord, are today celebrating the birth of the Lord Jesus. Amen. For what that's done in your life and mine. And here we are today to lift up the name of Jesus Christ, because we're as excited about what he has done for us and what he will do for a true believer today, a seeker, a searcher of life.
Amen.
The life giver is here.
That's right.
Oh my God, I don't get a chance to read, but let me just read something here today. For the life giver is here. Now, verse 18, the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when as his mother Mary was exposed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child. My God. Joseph exposed, or Mary exposed to be the wife of Joseph, a God-fearing man, hallelujah, who knew for certainty that he can't do anything intimately with this woman that is supposed to be. We have time to wait because they cannot come together unless they are ready to backslide from their faithfulness to God. But here the God-fearing man coming to realize something. It is not a dream, but the woman that he has chosen to marry to is now being pregnant. The Bible said he was such a man. When he saw this, he was, I would say my own word, with a big trouble and confused. But being a just man, he considered and started to think now in his mind, I'm not going to disgrace her, but I can't come together with her. I can't marry her anymore. These are my words. I'm just paraphrasing. I am going to put her away privately. But the Bible said when he began to think on these things, something special happened. And God spoke to Joseph and said, fear not, Joseph, to take unto thee Mary thy wife. Did he say that his supposed wife? Mary thy wife. Hallelujah. For that which is conceived in her is not as you thought. Of the Holy Ghost. You know, they will stop reading. I did not say the Holy Ghost, but she was found to be a child. That's where I stopped.
Yes.
Bishop,
yes.
What could have come to Joseph if he was not a God-fearing man?
Right.
Is some of the things that we're experiencing today.
Yeah.
You show me today that man who had a woman set aside and ready to marry to her. And that man, yes, that man had this woman, he's excited about her, and she is a Christian, and that's what he wants. And because of how he's put away the last remain of our brother, amen, our father, amen, our friend and neighbor, but God even in his depths bring a blessing to me. God is here to bring a blessing to someone today. Hallelujah. And thank God I'm being baptized with the Holy Ghost, because it is the Holy Ghost that is keeping me alive spiritually and well. Sometimes, you know, brethren, something comes. My God Almighty, if you don't mind, you give up. Hallelujah, hallelujah. But when the Holy Ghost touches you, it makes a difference. I want somebody to make touch with the Holy Ghost today. He's here to save you. He's here to deliver you. He's here that we may have life. My God Almighty. And I'm not talking. I'm not inviting you to come and join to us today. I'm talking to you today. If you want to be saved, you've got to believe the word.
Yeah.
Joseph believed the word, and all that was troubling his mind was now over. Immediately, he took home his wife and kept her at his home, abstaining from her, and wait for that precious gift that is sent to the entire world. That gift was yours. If you are here today and you're being entangled with sin and you can't even pray, you feel feel that place. You are in a afraid of church. The gift belongs to you. God will bring you in and set you up in the church that you don't know. When you start to perform some things, you wonder, is this me? So God will clean you. When he takes someone in, he cleans you up. He sets you up for himself. The enemy doesn't like it. He will bring something to your mind, but ignore him. Life is what you want. I have to stop somewhere. Life is what you want. Hallelujah. I'm encouraging you today. Hallelujah. What God requires of us is to genuinely repent of our sins and come to him and accept him as our personal Savior. Hallelujah. And he will give to you, hallelujah, the hope of eternal life. He will give to you the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. The Bible said that they begged leave in the womb of Elizabeth. My God, because God was doing there had to be a connection. Amen. Because the Holy Ghost was Mary and the baby inside. Remember the Bible said John was born full of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. So when that baby leaped on the inside, my God, the Holy Ghost came and John born from his mother's womb full of the Holy Ghost and being a Holy Ghost man, my God Almighty, and knew that he was not the one. He learned to keep himself in subjection. I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness, preparing the way of the Lord and make his path straight. He's coming. What is he talking about? Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. It's not me. Hallelujah. He said, I baptize you in water. Hallelujah. Unto repentance, saying unto you, you should believe on him that should come after me. Because he's so great, I am not worthy to stoop down and loose his shoes latchet. I baptize you in water, but when he comes, he shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire. Fire to burn out sin. Fire to burn out hatred, wickedness, ungodliness, all the things that have been robbing you and keeping you from serving God. The Holy Ghost is come. Hallelujah. When he comes, he is going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. Hallelujah. I'm encouraging you today, if you are even a religious person, but you're conscious today, you're not being baptized with the Holy Ghost. You are in the right place. And I'm not talking about this building now. But the truth is, without the Holy Ghost, the Bible said we are none of these. You talk about the rapture? It is the rapture that makes you, it is the Holy Ghost that makes you fit. I'm ready for the rapture.
Yes.
Is that a plane that is taking you up there?
All
right. Is that a plane?
No.
It can't go up there. When planes go too high and go to where they should, you hear the news that they are searching, trying to find them. They just disappear. And certainly they're not going to heaven. God knows what an airplane up there. They just disappear. If you want to make heaven, Jesus is the way. I am the way, the truth, and the life.
No man.
No man. My God Almighty. If you don't come to Jesus, you are in the wrong part. And I'm not troubling anybody, church, no man. Because I believe personally, a believer, a sincere person can stay anywhere and receive the Holy Ghost. True seeker, receive the Holy Ghost. Wherever you may be, because God is searching for something special. And if he finds it here, he's going to grab it. If you go to the Seventh-day Adventist Church and find that one, he's going to grab it. The word is going to reach somebody from anywhere, and that word is going to arrest you and bring you in the presence of God. We're afraid of death, but something more is there for us to be more concerned about than that. I was sitting there and the thought that came to me, death for the Christian, true Christian believer, is not something for us to be afraid about. It is the limousine that comes to take you when the work is over, out of this life, and to allow you to go where by the Spirit go back to God with you. The person that refuses the word of God and stay until death comes before you're prepared and ready is not the same limousine. I don't know how much you here today knows about the Black Maria, or whatever the name was. That vehicle that they use to dispatch and to carry the prisoners, and when they get their sentence, to bring them to a place of security for them to pay for the wrong they have done. If I die without Christ, death to me would be that vehicle. You're being arrested without any freedom until the judge set you free. But the Bible said, may the true fall, you shall it die. There is no repentance in the grave. But no matter who you are today, murderer, thief, fornicator, adulterer, amen, looter, whatever you want to do today, you have been doing, amen. I am saved. While there is life today, there is hope. But the Bible said, if you hear my voice, harden not your heart, but come and yield. So the murderer or the thief or the robber, whatever, the looter, the scammer, whoever you are, can come to yourself and repent and acknowledge your wrong and turn to God. God can take you out of scamming, out of stealing, out of being a murderer, and turn around to love souls and preach and teach the people to come to the Lord. I invite you today, wherever you are, hallelujah, don't look at the number of the sins that you have committed. Look at the fact that you have done wrong, and it's time for me. For me, I'm saying for you, it's time for you to repent and turn to God. I'm going where I've heard that my sins shall be remitted and taken away and be forgotten, and I come to have the hope of eternal life. This hope is for every true believer today. If you have not yet started, you can start right now. Is there anybody want to come today? Is there anybody want to come today? Just come, because God is able. These are my few words in Jesus' name. Yes, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Make right with God. And if you are here and you were a believer and you step away from righteousness, there's a chance for you to return to the Lord and make your calling and election sure. Praise the Lord. At this time, we are going to invite the family. We need to pray for you before you go. Many have gone already, many are outside. But wherever you are, our prayers can reach you. Yes, the hand of God can touch you anywhere you are. So I'm going to ask the family to stand, come forward. And if those who are outside can step in. decided to get some prayer to carry you on. Praise the altar.
decision. But God, with you all things are possible, and we're committing everyone into your hand for your care and protection. And we speak specially now, God, of Sister Sin. We thank you for the strength you have given to her. Pray that thou would continue to bear her up. Give her the strength, God, as she trusts in thee. We bless your name and we give you thanks as we ask all these favors in your name, in Jesus' name.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again, when I see you again.
Damn. All the planes we flew, good things we've been through, then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place.
See you in a better place.
How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I see you again.
We've come a long way,
yeah, we came a long way
from where we began.
You know we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
Let me tell you.
When I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong. It was small, turn to a friendship turn to a bond. And that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn. And that line is what we reach, so remember me when I'm gone.
How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way. Yeah. Hold every memory as you go. And every road you take. Without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again, when I see you again.
Yeah.
Lord, make me to know my end and the measure of my days, what it is, that I may know how frail I am. In the midst of life, we are in death. Of whom may we seek for succor, but of thee, O Lord, who for our sins are justly displeased. Man that is born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. Cometh forth like a flower and is cut down. He fled also as a shadow and continueth not. Thou knowest, Lord, the secrets of our hearts. Shut not thy merciful ears to our prayers.
For as much for as the spirit of the departed has returned to the God of the ages, we therefore commit the body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the coming of the Lord, when he himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God. The dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Praise the Lord. Okay, you may go ahead.
Give you picture one.
Sing.
When the morning comes,
when all of time and death are gone,
how we overcome,
and it's the
first time we by and by.
When all the saints of God shall gather on, we will tell the story.
Yeah.
Bless the Lord. Father, we give thee thanks for your goodness and mercies toward us, God. We thank you for your support through the day, my God, and even for the holding up of the rain, God Almighty, to allow us to put forth this our duty, my God, to put the remainder of our brother away. We thank you, God Almighty, for such great support. We thank you for all the friends and families, everyone today, God, who participated in this action today. We pray, God, that you will bless the people, God Almighty, as they will be going from this spot, my God. I'm just asking you to protect them and to guide them along the journey, Lord Jesus. We thank you for all things as we ask it now in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'd just like to say an acknowledgement here. Family of Donald Sims extend all the gratitude and appreciation there as to everyone. We could not have done it without your prayers, love, care, and support. God bless you all. Thank you all for your support. God bless you. Let's continue.
Amen.